We are glad the Dauphin is so pleasant with us. His present and your pains we thank you for. When we have matched our rackets to these balls, we will in France, by God's grace, play a set, shall strike his father's crown into the hazard. Tell him that he hath made a match with such a wrangler that all the courts of France will be disturbed with chases. And tell the pleasant prince that this mock of his hath turned his balls to gunstones, and his soul shall stand sore charged for the wasteful vengeance that shall fly with them. For many a thousand widows shall this his mock mock out of their dear husbands, mock mothers from their sons, mock castles down. And some are yet ungotten and unborn that shall have cause to curse the Dauphin's scorn. So get you hence in peace, and tell the Dauphin that his jest will savor but of shallow wit when thousands weep more than did laugh at it.
Behold, I have a weapon. A better never did itself sustain upon a soldier's thigh. I have seen the day that, with this little arm and this good sword, I have made my way through more impediments than 20 times your stop. But, O vain boast, who can control his fate? 'Tis not so now. Be not afraid, though you do see me weaponed. Here's my journey's end, here's my butt, and very sea mark of my utmost sail. Do you go back dismayed? 'Tis a lost fear. Man, but a rush against Othello's breast, and he retires. Where should Othello go? Now, how dost thou look now, O ill-starred wench, pale as thy smock? When we shall meet at Compt, this look of thine will hurl my soul from heaven, and fiends will snatch at it. Cold, cold, my girl, even like thy chastity. O cursed, cursed slave! Whip me, you devils, from the possession of this heavenly sight. Blow me about in winds, roast me in sulfur, wash me in steep down gulfs of liquid fire. Oh, Desdemon! Dead, Desdemon! Dead! Oh! Oh!
My noble father, I do perceive here a divided duty. To you I am bound for life and education. My life and education both do learn me how to respect you. You are the lord of duty. I am hitherto your daughter, but here's my husband. And so much duty as my mother showed to you, preferring you before her father, so much I challenge that I may profess due to the more, my lord. My heart's subdued, even to the very quality of my lord. I saw Othello's visage in his mind, and to his honors and his valiant parts did I my soul and fortunes consecrate. So that, dear lords, if I be left behind, a moth of peace, and he go to the war, the rights for why I love him are bereft me, and I a heavy interim shall support by his dear absence. Let me go with him.